हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ कोमल एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लास 9th ज्योग्राफी टॉपिक चैप्टर नंबर 12 इंसुलेशन. इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इंसुलेशन पार्ट्स एंड इंसुलेशन हाउ इट इज टेक्स प्लेस, हाउ द रेडिएशंस आर कमिंग एंड हाउ दीज रेडिएशंस आर अफेक्टिंग आर अर्थ्स एटमोसफेयर. सो आई विल स्टार्ट दिस टॉपिक विद द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ सन. So firstly, I will start this topic with the sun's description. As you know that sun is the ultimate source of light. It is giving energy and afterward we are generating that energy to the different forms. So sun radiation that are reaching to the earth's surface, they are taking 30,000 km per second speed at the earth within 8 minutes. That means within 8 minutes we are getting 30,000 km per speed second solar radiations. Then insolation that reaches to Earth's surface is nearly about 23 billion horsepower. They are generating the 23 billion horsepower energy. Then heat transmission that is happened through the radiations only. And the radiations further, if we will classify the radiation, there are two types. First radiation type is the insolation and the second one is terrestrial radiation. So the next is in the types of radiation, insolation. The definition part, insolation are the amount of heat or sun, that is heat or sun radiations received by the earth. This is called the simple definition for insolation. The amount of heat which is received by the earth's surface, that is called the insolation. On the other side, terrestrial radiation which is reflected back by the earth to the atmosphere or to the space area, that is the terrestrial radiation. In insolation, out of 100%, we are getting only 60% heat to the earth surface. And out of those 60%, which is divided into the atmospheric heat to the atmosphere of earth and the, to the ground area. Then terrestrial radiation, uranium, thorium and radium emits radioactive material, which is naturally in this process. So, the heating of the atmosphere, how it is going to be heated, I will explain it through the diagram. Insolation, when the sun energy coming to the earth surface, it is in 100%. When it reaches to the earth surface, it is divided into two areas. 15% out of 100%, 15% is absorbed by the atmosphere in various gases. Then the 45% which is reaches to the ground, that means total 60%, and the percentage 40% which is reflected back to the atmosphere, that is 40%, and it is goes to the space area. Now the air gets warm due to the radiation. So due to the heating process, Earth's atmosphere is heated by the three main processes. First is convection, second conduction, and the third one radiation. In conduction process, air gets warmer and it becomes goes to the upper side, and in convection it goes to the circular motion. So next topic is differential heating of the land and water. In this, land gets heated faster during the daytime, but in water bodies cold wind blows, so it is moderately heated. As you know that land becomes heated faster as compared to the water bodies, because in water surface cold wind is blowing, so due to that cold wind create a pressure between among the heating of the the insulation and toward the land surface or to the water surface. So there is a pressure between both. So land becomes heated faster as compared to the earth, as compared to the water surface. Then the next thing is the water, the factors which are affecting the distribution of temperature. So in factors part, the factors are divided into 8 points. First one is latitude, second altitude, third one is distance from sea, fourth ocean currents, clouds and rainfall, slope of the land, vegetation and nature of soil. All these are the factors of distribution of temperature. So temperature, firstly the latitude, it is totally affecting the earth's temperature. How? The areas which are closer to the equator, they are having higher temperature, they are having direct sun rays, and they are having their travel lesser extent through the atmosphere. On the other side, the areas which are having higher latitude, they are experiencing lower temperature, sun rays are also slant, and travelers greater extent through the atmosphere. Then next thing is altitude. In the altitude point, high altitude, low temperature areas are considered. So high temperature will be there in the lower altitude areas, denser air near the surface of the earth which contains gases like CO2, water vapor, etc., that absorb by the heat. Then the next thing is distance from sea. In distance from sea, the areas which are closer to the sea, they are having moderate temperature. As you learned from in the earlier classes in 6th, 7th, 8th, you are already reading about the distance from sea. The areas which are closer to sea, they are having moderate temperature due to the influence of sea or the water bodies, and areas which are away from the sea or the coastal areas, they are experiencing fluctuate temperature, like high temperature in the summer and low temperature in the winter season. So the oceanic or equable climate, for example, Mumbai have the low diurnal annual range of temperature, as Mumbai city is located on the coastal. It is also known as a coastal city. Then areas away from the sea are the continental extreme type. For example, they have given the Nagpur city. They are having extreme type of climate because that area is away from the sea. Then ocean currents are of two types. First one is warm current and the second one cold currents. Warm currents, which are blow from the equatorial to the polar region and increase the temperature and makes the coastal area warmer. And in the cold currents, move from the polar region to the lower equatorial latitude and decreases the temperature and makes the coastal area cooler. On the other side, clouds and rainfall, if absence of cloud is there, clouds are not visible in the particular place, then these condition arises that high temperature is there in the diurnal range of temperature. For example, deserts, they are not having much clouds. So that's why extreme condition of temperature is there. Temperature is always on the peak point. Then presence of cloud. If presence of cloud is there, for example, mountainous area, they are having more rainfall. They are having very less temperature. Moderate the temperature, prevent insolation from reaching the earth surface, and they also prevent the terrestrial radiation to escape equatorial regions. Now, then next point is slope of the land. In the slope of land, we are discussing about the south facing slopes in the northern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere, they are having the following qualities like warmer, sun rays strike at a steeper angle. That means the sun rays are always slant. Then the next is vegetation. Vegetation in which we are discussing about the forest. The first is checks radiation from the upper layers of the soil. So upper layer, which is directly contact with the sun rays, they are having the radiation directly. So that's why it is having the content of the solar part. Then the lesser range of temperature variation, lower temperature that ocean, that open places. Then the nature of soil. In nature of soil, if we are having dark colored soil, so they are absorbing more heat. So they are becomes very much fertile, like alluvial soil, black soil. They are the fertile soils. Then loamy and clay soil, they are retaining water. So humidity should be needed in these areas. Then sandy, they are not absorbs and release heat quickly. So that's why they are infertile. So you can understand that heat is also essential for the soil fertility. So the next topic is about the description of the factors. The first one I will discuss you, I will tell you how this effect of altitude happening in the earth surface. The first point is, with the increase of height, temperature decreases. For every 166 meters, the temperature falls by 1 degree Celsius. You can understand that every 166 meter, the temperature falls by 1 degree Celsius. As you will go upward, like in the figure, they have given one description of mountain figure. In that, if you will go on the increasing altitude, then from the 80 degree Fahrenheit to 75 degree Fahrenheit, that means temperature decreases with the 166 meter. Then temperature falls to the 60 degree Fahrenheit if we will reach on the top of the mountain. So there is the rarefaction of air should be considered on the opposite side of the mountain. Now, the next is the temperature inversion. In temperature inversion, how it is happening that temperature fluctuate due to the cold air and the hot air. When they are sinking below the land surface part, they are having the calm air. That means the air becomes hot and cold. They are mixing each other and they are becoming, they are making it as a calm. Not much cold, not much hot. So cold air collects the valley bottom in the center area. Then distance from sea. In this diagram you can clearly see that the areas which are near to the sea, they are having sea absorbs heat slowly. So 10 degree Celsius is there on the upper floor of the waterbed. That is in the Fahrenheit scale it is a 50 degree Celsius. It's a cool wind is blowing over there. When it goes to the land surface area or to the coastal area, coastal region, it becomes hot. Warmer air is going to be blow. So 15 degree Celsius temperature becomes to be from 10 degree to 15. The next thing is outgoing heat from the earth. If 5 degree Celsius temperature is there in the sea, then it automatically shifted to the 0 degree Celsius when it goes to the coastal part. Then effects of clouds. In effects of clouds, by the daytime when heat is coming from the sun, the earth surface becomes hot. So they have given in the description over here that 26.7 degree Celsius temperature. When cloud absorb and reflect a good deal of solar radiation, when clouds are also formed, at that time 26.7 degree Celsius temperature in the good day weather. And by the night time, when clouds are also appeared and earth surface becomes losing its heat, so at that time the temperature falls to the 21 degree Celsius. That means automatically about 5.7 degree Celsius falls down. Then the slope of land. How? In the slope of land, if earth surface or the particular land mass is on the upper condition of the altitude, then the warm winds prevail to the upper area and the warming air continental area, they are making it a marine type and continental type climate. Then effect of direction of the slope of land. How it is that? That effect of direction, it is happening when south facing slopes are there, they are having more sunny. We are considering that the parallel rays are coming from the sun and they are making that south area more sunny. So it is a totally factful thing that direction of the slope is making land heater. Then up to this my topic is over, but before that I want to tell you about the convection, conduction and radiation. What is a convection? In convection, that the transmission of heat from one part of a liquid or gas to another by movement of particles themselves is called a convection. Then that means the heat is transferred from one liquid or gas to the other movement, by the other movement to other thing. By that the earth is getting warmer. In this process we can give the example of the water boiling. Water, when we place one container on the gas stove, when heat is lighted up, the water becomes boiled and the heat is transferred into the gas form to that particular object. So this is an example of convection, how heat is transferring to the another object. Then conduction. In conduction, the conduction is process in which heat is transferred directly through the metal from a point of high temperature. At a high temperature, we are transferring one heat to the another thing. Like that, we can take one example for this is a hot to cold object. Like that, if we will place one container that is very hot near to the cold object, and when it will come in contact, they will become hotter. So by contacting with one object of heat to the other object, that is a conduction process. Then the next is radiation. In radiation, energy emits through the radiance. So this is the totally energy which is received by the sun. So sun radiation is there. Up to this chapter is over. If you will get any query, you can ask me through comment section. And one more thing, you have to solve the exercise of this chapter and you have to draw all these diagrams which I am going to show over here, which I have shown over here. You have to draw all these diagrams in your notebooks. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.